and he will not forgive him. Sheikh Zayd ibn Muhammad rahimahullah rahmatan wasi'a, he say سبق أن عصاة الموحدين تحت مشيئة الإلهية. He say وما لهم إلى الجنة. He say we had already covered that the sinners among the people of Tawheed, the sinners among the people of Tawheed, they did not ascribe any partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but they fell short in certain sins. So the usat, meaning the sinners among the people of Tawheed, that they are under the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but their final destination, their final abode will be what? The Jannah. Their final abode will be the Jannah. So it is to, we can say that all the believers, all the people of Tawheed will be what? Will be in the Jannah. Even if he is an alcoholic, even if he is used intoxicant, or even he is like a perpetrator, a murderer, or he is like a fornicator, that his final abode will be what? Will be the Jannah. This is the mawqif Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Being just, being middle course. So he mentioned, he say, وَمَا لُهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ, that their final abode will be the Jannah. إن شاء الله, he say, عَاقَبَهُمْ بِالنَّارِ, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants, if he wills, he will punish them with the fire. وَإِن شَاءَ عَاقَبَهُمْ بِدُونِ ذَلِكَ, but if Allah wills, he can punish them with other than what? Other than the hellfire. He can punish them with other than the hellfire. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants, he can punish them yawm al-qiyamati with the hellfire, or he can punish them without the hellfire. Without the hellfire. This is why the Salaf, they say that if a calamity befall on them, they will look whether it is a trial or whether it is what? A punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So certain things or certain times, an individual might be going through certain things, but this is really a punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It could be also a trial and a tribulation. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is raising his martaba yawm al-qiyamati. He's going in hardship, yani throughout hardship. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to raise his level yawm al-qiyamati. But it could be also a trial, a calamity that befall on him as a punishment, saving him from the punishment of the hereafter. So the Shaykh Hafidhahullah Tabaraka wa ta'ala, he mentioned, he say, وَلَمْ يَدْخُلُهُمُ النَّارِ وَلَمْ يُدْخِلُهُمُ النَّارِ, that he will punish them with other and he will not enter them the hellfire. He say, فَالْحُكُمُ إِلَيْهِ, that the judgment is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However Allah is going to do with them, it is in his hands. And he said, وَهُوَ عَالِمٌ بِأَحْوَالِ عِبَادِهِ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the one that knows, alaykum salam, he is the one that knows the situation or the level point of his servants. He say, وَمَالُ الْعَاصِ الْمُسْلِمِ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ, but the bottom line is that the sinner among the Muslims, the sinner among the people of Tawheed, their final abode will be the Jannah. This is to be understood. And he say, يُشْفَعُ فِيهِ الشَّافِعُونَ بِأَمْرِ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى, those who will intercede, or those who will be given the authorization to intercede, they will intercede for them by the authorization of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they believe that the intercession has how many conditions? How many conditions? Omar? Three. He say three. Abu Asma? Three. Huh?
He don't want to dive in. Allah yubarik fiik.
Mustafa? We covered this few miraran wa takraran. ثلاثة ثلاثة اثنان ثلاثة اكتبوا. And alhamdulillah, what we're going to cover tonight, بإذن الله تعالى, especially when we're going to read Sheikh Ubaid, there will be a lot of notes to write. All right, for those who say two, who say two? You say two. Who say three? اختلاف. ما عندك؟ ثلاثة أيوة بين لنا. He say three. Three condition of shafa'ah. What are they?
أن يكون سافر
Say it in English. Intercession.
Allah agreed to do
the intercession. Okay.
And then the second of whoever doing it, they have their pardon in Allah.
Right. To being pleased by Allah. Okay.
Yeah.
Third one.
The third one will be a salmon.
Okay, those who are, you say how many?
Three.
Fadal, Abba Ahmed.
The one he make intercession. Tawheed. Somebody he had Tawheed.
Somebody to have Tawheed, person of Tawheed.
Yeah.
Number two.
The Allah to give me permission.
The permission. Thalithan. The other one, the third one to have the, I mean, the third one, the permission for the other one. Abba Asma? Oh, you didn't say the number.
No, huh? I said three.
Three. Number one?
It's similar to what he said, but then if he was to do two for a different situation, it would be, can I say it?
I'm listening.
A little
specific. But he said general and specific. Abba Ismail?
No.
He said two? Qulta, Aywa, number one? Ba'da Ithnillah, number two.
You have to be also people of the Tawheed. You have to be Radi for them.
You have to be people of Tawheed and Radi Nan. So that's three or two.
That's a two.
Okay, so number one is people of Tawheed.
People of Tawheed.
Thaniyan.
Thaniyan, you have to be intercession for those who have to be Radi for them.
That those who the intercession will be done on, they have to be Radi Anhum. Thalithan.
Yeah,
this is two. Okay, two. All right. Number three. Oh, yeah, you say two. I'm sorry. Three.
Allah grant the permission.
The permission from Allah.
From the people of Tawheed.
And he got to be pleased with those who are being, the intercession being done unto them. Just check on the outside, please. All right. Anybody else says number three? Omar? Yes. Allah has to be pleased with the one that he is, the intercession, the one that is doing the intercession, number three. Number two? That he gotta be pleased with the one that is being interceded onto.
And the third one is gotta be
And the third one has to be from the people of Tawheed, Uktubu. These are the three one. The number one, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has to give the permission for whoever is the intercessor. Number two, that the one being interceded for has to be pleased by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And number three, it is to be by the people of Tawheed. By the people of Tawheed. Tayyib. So therefore he mentioned, no.
For the second one, Allah has to be pleased with both, like the one who
the intercession. Allah has to give the authorization for the one, giving intercession. And the one to be interceded for, Allah has to be pleased with that. And the third one is that he has to be from the people of Tawheed. Tayyib. So here he mentioned that Sheikh Zayd ibn Muhammad, he mentioned rahimahullah. He say that they could be interceded for those who will be granted to intercede by the permission of Allah. وَيَخْرُجُ اللَّهُ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will exit them out min an-nar, from the hellfire. He say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will exit out from the people, from the hellfire. Aqwa man, a people. He say, qad imtahashu, that they have been burnt. So fal yulqawna fi nahri jannah. They will be, dropped in the river of, in the jannah. So therefore, hatta takmil ajsadihim, until that their whole body will be what? Will be complete again. Until their body will be complete again. Tayyib. Until their body will be complete again. So they will be taken out from the hellfire and they will be placed in the river. Tayyib. and until their body will be completed, he say, وَتُعَادُ إِلَيْهِمْ أَرْوَاحُهُمْ, and their soul will be placed back to them. He say, وَيُدْخِلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ, and they will enter the Jannah. So this shows Barakallah, and these were from the people of Tawheed. These were from the people of Tawheed. These were from the Ussad, the sinners of the people of Tawheed. So this is to show Barakallah Fikum, the important matter, the most important fundamental matter. It is about knowing a Tawheed and to stick with it, to hold on to it, and knowing a shirk to be away, far away, removed from it. Now. Yes, yes, yes. Because one of the things that the hellfire, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, that whenever their skins will be out, بَدَّلْنَاهُمْ جُلُودًا غَيْرَهَا, that we will give them another skin, لِيُذِيقَ الْعَذَابِ, so they can test the punishment. Depending on what's the innovation. If the innovation is mukaffira, la. But if there was mufassiqa, meaning in the action, not in the i'tiqad, then this will be, they will be, their final abode will be in the Jannah. But they will be prevented from what? From drinking from the hawd. They will be prevented from drinking from the hawd. They will not drink from the hawd. طيب. So Shaykh Zayd ibn Muhammad, he mentioned, rahimahullah, he said, وَأَمَّا الْمُشْرِكِ. Now if when it comes to the mushrik, وَالْوَثَنِيِّينَ, and those who are the idol worshippers, وَالْمَجُوسِ, and the magians, وَالْمُلَاحِدَ, and the atheists, وَالْمُنَافِقِينَ, and the hypocrites, نِفَاقُ اِعْتِقَادِيًا, those hypocrites, that their hypocrisy is upon what? Is based upon the belief system. Because النِفَاق ينقسم إلى قسمين. You have two types of hypocrisy. The hypocrisy of the action and the hypocrisy of the belief. The hypocrisy of the belief, take the individual out of the fold of Islam. He can be praying day and night. He can be fasting the whole year, 365 days. He can be going to Hajj every year or Umrah every month. Or he could be giving sadaqah all his wealth. But ma dama annahu nafaqa, as long as he has that nifaq i'tiqadiyan, and he has this belief, the hypocrisy of the belief, then he is, barakallahu fikum, not to be what? Taken as a Muslim. He's not to be taken as a Muslim. So he mentioned, wal ilhad al mukhrij min al millah من اليهود والنصارى, and likewise those who are the atheists and those who are from the milal, meaning the religion of the Yahud and the Nasara. So these individuals, he said that they will be in هؤلاء لا شفاعة فيهم, that they will not have no intercession. That the Yahud, the Nasara, the Mulahida, the atheists, the Wathaniyin, the idol worshippers, the Majus, they will not have no intercession except one. Man whom? Man huwa? Except one that will have intercession. Mukhtar?
You were here this morning, right?
Yes. Except one. Abu Talib, Asanta. And he will have the lowest or the least punishment in the hellfire because of how much he has put forth for the deen of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because how he has, barakallahu fikum, taken the forefront in defending the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How he did benefit the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But still, he will be wearing some shoes of that will make his brain boil. And he will have the least ahwanul adab in the hellfire. He will have the least punishment or the least severe punishment. And if the least punishment will be that you will have some shoes that will make your brain boil. Now, akhi barakallahu feekum, for you to have something